mas okay yun. Very...
Before mas malaki yung stage.
Abot hanggang ground floor yun. Perfect. Sorry, tito. Ay, Mars, ang cute ang ano mo, oh, yung baby.
May ganyan.
Ano yan? Ano yan? Clip. Aww. Meron bang ibang anong ganyan? Ano naman? Saan ka makakabili ng ganyan? Ay, bonggong cute. Oo. Baka umihi siya dyan, ha? Hi guys! Welcome to the live streaming of Pageant Trend, and we are live here now at the Belmont Hotel for the Miss Universe Philippines 2024 Chelsea Manalo Victory Press Conference. And for those who are not yet following the Pageant Trend, of course, follow nyo na siya guys, follow nyo na tong page na to for more updates about pageants. And later on, makikita na natin ang ating newly crowned Miss Universe Philippines na si Chelsea Manalo. All the way from Bulacan. Yeah, don't forget to share, tag your friends. Para makapanood sila at i-cheer nyo ang ating bagong Miss Universe Philippines.
Sino yan?
Si Rian Ramos. Chelsea!
Hindi mo kaya magwawagi ng malaking ano?
Once again, please don't forget to share this live streaming, guys, to your friends and relatives, and as well as tag your friends so that they can watch our live streaming fresh from the crowning of our Miss Universe Philippines, this is Chelsea. So we're still waiting, guys. Comment yun na kung gusto nyo magpa-shoutout. Basahin natin yung habang may time pa, habang wala pa si Chelsea later on, makikita na natin siya. First, of course, we would like to congratulate Chelsea Manalo for winning the Miss Universe Philippines 2024 crown. Once again, don't forget to follow Pageant Trend for more updates about pageant.
Mga Mima, pwede naman makasingil naman dyan sa space na ito, Mima. Diyos ko, Lord.
Mima!
Wala na nga po.
Hi, Bernadette. Bernadette Garbo, shout out to you. Thank you so much for tuning in and for watching.
Ano ba yun? Eme.
Kita nolik, wag naman.
Ayaw
mo. Ayaw, okay na, okay na. Ayaw mo ba? Okay na.
Si baka matumba.
Ay!
Sinong ano?
Shit! Hoy, hindi ka naka-anong sa akin, no?
Sabi, andito ka na nga si So.
Yes,
bakit? Oh my God! Hello! Hello po sa newly crowned Miss Universe Philippines from Bulacan, Garbo. Maraming salamat po. Please don't forget to share this live streaming.
Awan! Pinamalog naman ni! Ay, ayoko na nga. Asin ko na nga to. Asin ko na nga. OPMB na nga lang. Asin ko na nga. Uy, nakalive na si Tito Noli.
Oo.
Good PM to all OPMB followers.
Hello!
Hello, hello sa lahat ng followers ng Pageantology. Live pa tayo.
Hindi pa nakalive. Hi, Eda. Aklarit Pandan. Pa-shout out naman po. Watching from Mindanao, Iligan City. Maraming salamat po for watching. Please don't forget to share this live streaming, guys.
Chelsea! Naka-blue! Naka-blue si Chelsea! Chelsea Husay!
Chama, no. Bustos, Bulacan.
Ay, bongga. Chelsea Tayuman. Chelsea Tayuman.
Ayan na, nakalive na.
Iya naman ang crossing our fingers na
nakapag-call. Magpa-voice over na ba tayo?
Basta siya dadaan.
Dito daw, sakit na. Alis pala tayo dito.
Marami tayong mga
pang-crowd. Ayan, ano ba yun?
Ano naman yun? May ano, may something.
Dapat kasi sinabi
na ako,
ano
pa yun talaga tayo sa lalo na sa mga mga team na. Nantay ka nyo.
Hi guys, we're still waiting for Chelsea na bumaba. Congratulations, May Queen Chelsea. Maraming salamat for your comment. Bon Noel Langley. Ayan, hi. Sabi ni Kathleen Susama Suza. What's that? Sujan. Hi, shout out po watching from Ireland. Congratulations. Maraming salamat guys for always supporting Pageant Trends sa aming mga pa-live and as well as sa pagre-react ng aming mga post. Huwag po kayo magsawang mag-react and as well as follow Pageant Trend for more updates about
Chelsea, Chelsea!
So what's up the moment? We are still waiting once again. Dumating si Chelsea. Nasa taas pa po siya ngayon. Kaya... And all of us are excited to see her right after the, you know, the coronation night.
Perfection na
yun. Perfection na yun. Alright, maraming salamat. Marmar Robledo Penonia. Shout out po watching from the mining capital of the Philippines. Municipality of Bayog. Wow, bongga. Saan po ba itong Bayog na to? Kasi may alam nung ko. Thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. Ayan, sabi ni Maria Teresa Gabriel, shout out po me. Ikaw po ba yung bosses na yun? Yes, ako yun to. Shout out po me. Ikaw po ba yung bosses na yun? Of course, ako to. Hindi ako picture. Eme. Char lang.
Siya yan, yung nakaputi, yung ang ulo.
Ito po, yung nakaputi ako. Eme. Like it. Watching from Malaysia. Wow, bongga. Thank you,
Alvin. Send star.
Char. And guys, kapag may mga extra kayo dyan, ha, baka naman pwede kayo mag-send ng stars. Kahit malang 100 stars, okay na yun. Masaya na po si, ano, si admin. And ang buong pageant trend.
Send po family. $100. Para kay J Barbo.
Award! Meron ba dito mga taga Bulacan? Shout out to all the Bulacanians and congratulations on behalf of Pageant Trend. Congratulations buong Bulacan. Hi, watching from Cebu, Maria Josel Mercader. Maraming salamat po for watching all the way from Cebu.
And so kudos to all of the delegates of this university for the
Manila. Let's give a shout out to all the followers, 600k followers na po tayo in and counting sa ating 65,000 viewers. Thank you so much, guys.
Ayan. May dumaan ng hell.
Sentimental favorite ko din, personally, si Christy Magari. Until last night, we were messaging her, exchanging messages, and, you know, congratulations, and acknowledgement that she did well talaga, super.
Yan na.
Miss Venezuela vibes yung ginawa na doon. Christy Magari, yung mga finals.
Andito na? Dito na siya! Ay, ayun na.
Kuya pala.
Andito na?
Ayan naman.
Sumigaw na ka.
Ay! Nagalawin naman natin ang kore tayo.
Ang pababa ng kore.
Dito kay Pasar.
Halak.
Pwede ka lang.
Perfect?
Baba.
Pwede naman ganun.
Yan, para sa'yo. Mahal ka namin eh.
Baba pa.
Ay, sa ano ko eh. Hindi, ibaba mo pa kay Kuya. Tapos ipasok. Hindi, ipasok mo sa kapila. Ipasok mo sa loob. Sa loob mo ipasok. Para maayos. Yun.
Perfect.
Para harap na harap.
Perfect.
Sinap na kamagandang ah.
Ano? Ano? Lagyan ko na.
Okay.
Ah, ilaw?
Hindi.
Yung second phone ko para ano?
Ilaw.
Ilaw daw.
Wow ha. Kailangan tayo man. Para ma-monetize na tayo guys.
$500.
Para ma-monetize na tayo. Charot.
$5 million na daw.
For the...
Sa Anton daw. 5,000.
Guys, naman na kayo. Super.
but talagang ganito. Our predictions were based on the preliminary. So, it's still everybody's ball game up until the final. So, when you buy it, totoo yan, Terry. Pag ang destiny ang nag-work, maliligwa kahit sinong malalakas. Kung para sa'yo, sa'yo talaga, ibibigay. But ang mga ako dyan, kasi nga diba, mention na ng those are based on historical performance. And we're not saying that those will be the final results of the
Guys, kung may mga question kayo later on para kay Chelsea, just comment it down or comment down below. Babasahin natin yan later
something that is very predicted her to get the different now. I wish we could see more of that kind of crowd. During the finals night. Iba-iba din sila ng version, di ba? Kumbaga yung slow-mo na tapos.
Police pa rin po tapos yun
na yung mala, Chelsea Manali.
Watches from the Amanda.
Thank you so much. Personality.
Kapawak.
Ano ba yung damit ko kanina?
Hindi
ba yung damit
ko kanina? We're not really sure how the selection then it makes sense that some of the runners didn't come out again for the selection of other crowds. Although I'm 90% sure she is not eligible for other crowns except for Miss Universe. Kaya hindi po siya na Sabi ni Darwin, Cruz, my best friend, I'm kind of sad for her, but I'm really happy for Chelsea. I will support her journey. Excited ako. Madami din happy sa pagkapanalo ni Chelsea. Madami positive feedback sa kanya. Alam niyo, Chelsea and I had a sit down during the Aqua Boracay. In Aqua Boracay, because that was the time na parang na-late yung arrival ni Chelsea. And while I was sitting at the holding area, nandun dumating si Chelsea at nagkaroon kami ng, you know, little kind of catch-up moments. Talagang we wished her luck in her journey and we're so happy to see her kahit na na-late siya doon sa Aqua Boracay. And since then, nakitaan ko na si Chelsea na talagang fire sa kanyang pamamata. Although hindi yung gigil yung laban-laban, pero you know that she has the composure to continue despite the struggles she went through for Universe Philippines. And determined to make her country proud. They really deserve the support of all of us. Chelsea is very good in communication and I think she will be good. Nakita naman natin yan during the one-on-one interview. Na-test na natin yung kanyang
naka-white siya.
Talagang even
white, magandang white sa kanya.
Even the camera, she is really good. Parang talaga yung community niya sa kasi naman. You don't see her rattling, you don't see her pressure. You don't see her maybe it's because of the maturity and because of the experiences, the wisdom she gained through all of the experiences she had in life.
Hi, Chelsea.
Chelsea.
Tawagin mo naman sa
akin. Chelsea here.
Centers,
Chelsea.
Yun, beautiful. Tawagin mo naman sa akin naman.
Chelsea here.
Chelsea Santor here.
Hi.
Bucket.
Chelsea. Hi. Here, please. Chelsea here.
Hi. Here. One more here.
One more to center.
Center.
Chelsea.
Ating Miss Universe Philippines 2024 Chelsea.
Mag-start na po.
Start na tayo, mami. Chelsea, look lang
siya. Ay, ba?
Chelsea!
So, she's here, guys.
Chelsea!
Okay, Chelsea.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Thank you so much, everyone, for being here. I know many of you piyat pa rin. You're still trying to get over the whole fabulous finals of Miss Universe Philippines the other night.
Yes!
Finally, you got the pageant that you want. Diba, maliwanag?
Yes. Maliwanag, malaki.
HD quality.
Pasabog.
Super fun, super pasabog. The fans got what they want. And we have an amazing winner. Congratulations.
Thank you so much, Sir V. Thank you, everyone, for making it here. Finally, your love, Bulacanya. Your Miss Universe Philippines 2024 is here.
Yeah.
Wow! Love Bulacan sweets. I put the sweets. But thank you so much. I know it's been a long journey for our Miss Universe Philippines delegates and for the entire organization as well. So we thank you for sticking with us since February during the press presentation, all the way up to Sultan Kudarat and all the way up to the finals. We thank all of our sponsors and everybody who supported us, who supported all of the delegates, from the glam teams to their coaches, to their designers, and most of all, their families, their parents that have been there to support them, to embrace them. And now also to all the other delegates of Miss Universe Philippines that have competed and are probably resting at this moment, we also want to thank you from the bottom of our hearts for participating in this year's pageant. And Miss Universe Philippines is always open and welcome whenever you want to come over, and if you need help, if you need a job. But right now, our focus is Chelsea Manalo. And of course, you know, are you used to it yet when people keep calling Chelsea, Chelsea?
No. I still haven't, like, it still haven't sunk into my mind yet that I am already Miss Universe Philippines. But you know, when I am already here with everyone here, with my family, with my friends, I hold my sash and my crown to always keep me humble and to always remind myself that I am Miss Universe Philippines because I am here to represent, that I am here to win that fifth crown, and also that, you know, to give back to the Philippines. So I hope that everyone will still continue to support me, because I know it still feels surreal. It still feels surreal. But the people who are showing their support to me, I see it now. I don't think I should have done that, you know, going on my phone, because it's bombarded now. I can see the love. But yeah, the love and the support that I've been getting, not just from my co-candidates, but from all over the Philippines now, it's really heartwarming for me. And I'm really thankful for that. Maraming salamat.
What was it like this morning when you first had to do your first media guesting?
Oh, it was really fun. I have to say that I really liked it. I was here with Unang Hirif. I did it with them. It was really fun there. You know, they made me do my walk. We had a really fun interview. And they asked me about the crown and how it was like, you know, being Miss Universe Philippines, because I know everyone would like to know how it feels, but even I don't know how to say it and I don't know how to feel about it. You know, it holds so much honor and gratitude for me to be here in front of everyone. I'm really thankful for it.
I know you guys are dying to ask your questions. So, who wants to go first?
Drew Francis.
Chitan is here for the national costume.
That's a national.
Thanks so much. So sort of bold there. I'm actually wearing Sangamon Festival.
Wow, bongga!
In our home province, Bulacan. So just like you in Chelsea, I'm also a very proud Bulacanino.
Wow!
So I grew up in Pandi. Sorry po, akunting chika lang. Actually, first cousin mo si Pamangkin, yung hipag ko, si Isa Castro. And then, inaanak mo yung Pamangkin ko, si Colleen.
Ay, iba!
Family?
Family pala?
In Chelsea, curious ako kung anong pakiramdam mo every time you enter Bulacan, syempre. Syempre, when you enter to Bulacan, sa may kawayan pa lang, in your hometown. Sinasabi doon, welcome sa lalawigan ng mga bayani at nagagandahang dilag. So, nung bata ka pa, and then, syempre, you're striving to be, syempre, you're a dreamer, di ba? And then, you experience bullying then sa when you're young in Bulacan. So, anong feel mo, gaano nag-take na inspiration sa'yo yun, yung slogan na ganun sa Bulacan?
Kasi nung bata talaga ako, I didn't really see that beauty, you know, the standard of beauty in me. I had to just really keep in the thought of my parents, you know, to always believe in myself, to uphold the values that you have, because you will grow into it, you will shine, you will grow further. And whenever I come home to Bulacan, you know, it's my home. I feel happy when I am at my hometown. It's been a while since I have been back there. So when I come back, I know that the heartwarming Bulaqueños, you know, will be happy to see me, and I can't wait to see them too.
Wow. And so just last night, I watched your bio, your story in YouTube, and then syempre nag-flashback when you joined a national pageant during 2017, and then before that, syempre you went to the US to study. So, sobrang, parang you were trained as a gladiator somehow for the pageant, di ba? So, pero ano sa yung biggest lesson that you will remember and conquer them na nasa sa puso mo talaga? And you can give advice to young aspirant Filipina?
So, my first national pageant was Miss World. That was 2017. I was 17 back then. And I wanted to join a pageant so that I can really experience how it is like. You know, I was a dreamer of beauty pageants. I love joining beauty pageants, and I love seeing beauty queens as well. This has really inspired me to become one like. And because of that, you know, I have always uphold the values that my parents have told me. And I want to be that woman of representation as well, you know. So to every woman of color, and not just every woman, you know, any woman at all who was here to support me, I just want to say that, you know, to believe in yourself. If you really love pageantry, if you have a dream, then go for it. Take risks. It's not too late for you to try it out. I mean, Miss Universe Philippines have actually open a lot of standards for every woman. You know, there are married women here, there are mothers, there are also at the under age of 18, you know, because they have dreams and anyone can really get to it. I started young, I had a dream for it, and now I'm here to, you're now Miss Universe Philippines, so I hope that I can be that inspiration to them.
Wow, sa aming Reina. Go for the fifth round, Queen Chelsea. Okay,
yes.
Parang nakaramdaman na namin yun.
So much. Mm-hmm. Ah.
Buhay Chelsea, I'm Armin Adina from the Philippine Baby Choir. First of all, congratulations from the
Thank
community
you.
Of Padilla sa Araneta
so
University. Like you, I'm also a product of that university. I was there from preschool to high school. Akala mo, ito ni Kona.
Award?
Connection.
Connection.
Senior high school hanggang college, graduated there. Here's my question. There was a post by Rod Singh saying that you almost quit. Can you confirm that and tell us what happened and what kept you going?
Oh, so, well, what happened really was because I really had financial issues. I think most of the girls actually had that problem as well. But as for me, because I joined here as an independent woman, everything that I had to go through the pageant, you know, I laid it out on myself. You know, I told my mom and my dad, I want to join this season for Miss Universe Philippines. So they really did support me. But because of this, I had to also risk of quitting my job. So because of that, the only income that I had was just a couple amounts. But because of that, you know, there were some issues about it and also some things that were happening behind my team. It really did put me at my most that I was about to quit. But thank God, you know, there are people who supported me to continue and push me to continue further. You know, I've actually had a lot of good help from the governor from Bulacan, so I would really like to say thank you to Governor Daniel Fernando for helping me and Vice Governor Alex Castro. You know, they have helped me so much when it comes to financial. It's no joke, or I would like to say that I thank all of the ladies for 4 months. You know, it's really scary, and it's a really long battle for all of us to fight it. You don't know where our resources will come because everyone would have to risk something, and this is what happened to me. But because of the support that I've been getting, you know, it made me continue, and now I'm here.
Hi, Chelsea. I'm Drew Francisco. Hello. So, a few days ago, you're just Miss Bulacan, Chelsea. Now, people recognize you as Miss Universe Philippines. This is scary.
I have to say a little bit, yes. But that's not in a negative way. I think what scares me is because I'm mostly excited. I've been saying this to my parents. I've been saying it to Sir B and to the team behind it. Like, I feel scared because I'm excited. I'm excited to always go out there. You know, I'm excited to talk to people. I'm excited to meet people. And it's not in a way that, you know, that I now hold the crown and the sash, but because there's so much opportunities that will come my way, and I'm so ready for it.
And now for my next question. Now that people recognize you as Chelsea, as the Miss Universe Philippines, without the crown and the makeup, who is Chelsea?
She's a very humble woman. She was raised by her parents, you know, to always just believe in yourself, you know, to be kind to people, because I have faced a lot of challenges, bullying and all that. You know, people would call me names and sometimes would tell me to not dream. But because of this, you know, my parents would always come into my head to just be kind to these people. No matter what challenges will come your way, you can really grow into a beautiful person. You are unique, and this is who I am, you know. Without everything, and even with the crown, it will never change.
Thank you.
Hi, Chelsea. I'm Nolly Burioso for Open Worldwide.
See you.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Okay. My question is, what do you consider the most difficult, or rather the most challenging time during the entire Miss Universe process, way back from February up to the finals night last Wednesday?
Oh, besides the coronation night, I think it's the national costume. But I have to say, I was really excited for this one, but I didn't expect that it's going to be that tiring, you know, because the costume itself, I mean, it's beautiful, but you have no idea, I think, how gracefully these ladies have to put out their costume and represent their hometown and their provinces and their team. But it's really tiring, honestly, because it was a full show that we want to give to the people, to the Sultan Kudarat. We want to give that to them and to just really put a really good show to them. Yeah.
Thank you.
Hi, Chelsea. Good afternoon.
Hi, good afternoon.
This is Jay from Pageant Trend. I just have two questions. So the first question is, I saw a video on the social media during backstage before Michelle D had her final walk. And you were, I guess you were praying. So I just want to know what's on your mind during that time.
So during that time, I was praying really hard because I think that was already the time when we were already announced as top 5 winners. We already have a title, of course. We just don't know the designation yet. But to be fair, I would like to say that during that time, I was only praying to have the Miss Universe Philippines crown. It's that I really dreamed to have. I told myself that I came in here because I want to have that purpose. I want to work with the organization to have put my advocacy out there, you know. So while I was there, I was praying really hard. I was reminding, you know, how humble I was and my parents and, you know, the dream of just that little girl of facing in a mirror with her hairbrush and reminding herself she's going to be Miss Universe Philippines. That is what I was praying for. And I'm really thankful for all the praise that I've actually been getting from my supporters. I told them there's nothing else I want but just prayers. And I hope that this continues until me competing to Mexico.
Nice, congratulations. And my second question for you is, now that you're wearing the crown and also the sash of the Philippines, of course, what's the hardest thing of winning that crown for you?
For now, it's really the pressure. I can really say that I was not really the front runner when I was competing. You know, there's a lot of beautiful girls. So for me to really see the standards of how they are, you know, it set the bar high. But because I am here winning and I have that crown and the sash, you know, I also want to just be that woman. I want to actually combine all of them, 53 ladies that I am right now, because they have really empowered me. You know, it's really difficult to just really showcase who I am, but because of these women, they have empowered me to become myself. So I know that even if it is hard, I can go further because I have so much support from my sisters and from the organization already.
Congratulations once again, dear.
Hi, Chelsea.
Hi.
I'm Edge.
Hello.
Oh, I have a simple question. Who's Miss Universe winner you look up to?
I have been asked about this, and I would love to say it's Miss Pia, you know, where it's back. She has really been, you know, the kind of woman that I really look up to. She joined a couple times, you know, because she really had that dream, you know, to never really step back on it. And that is what I transpired to be, you know, that no matter where I go in my life, I would still like to chase for that dream. And because of that, it made me get the crown from Miss Universe Philippines.
Right, you're gonna go to Mexico.
Yes, very much.
Yes!
Thank you
so
much.
Hi, Chelsea. Congratulations.
Hello.
From the crown Philippines.
Thank
it's
you.
So, nung sit-down interview pa lang namin sa'yo, we saw how solid you are. It's a solid team, you and with your parents.
Yeah.
And then it was a very emotional moment, the time they went up to on stage to greet you. Can you share, if you don't mind, the conversation that you had with your parents?
Well, I just told my mom to, actually kept telling her to not cry, you know, because I already have it. I'm your Miss Universe now. You should be crying tears of joy. But she kept on crying. Actually, she was crying before ano pa lang, before preliminaries. She didn't actually want to watch the show. Sabi niya, baka mahimatay daw siya. Pag-load ba siya ng coronation? Kasi she was already trembling before preliminaries. But when I saw her, when I already had the crown and the sash, I actually wanted to say that I wanted to see my parents, you know, already. But to be honest, my mom took a while to come to the stage because she couldn't walk. She was feeling so weak because of the emotions that she has been having. So yeah, I love my parents so much. Thank you, Mom and Dad.
Congratulations, Chef.
Hi, Elson John, Panad. I just want to take us to the moment. Yung pinatay nila yung pilaw, tapos magka-coordinate kayo. Ano yung pinag-usapan niyo doon?
Honestly, ako, I was telling her how much I love her. I love Ate Stacy. She has been literally just like an ate to me. And I have a lot of ates in the pageant palace. She was that woman that she would always ask you, how are you? What do you need? You know, is there anything I can help you with? She's going to keep on reminding me that. So when I was holding that hand with her, I kept on telling her how much I love her, because no one else will tell us during the backstage. We were all just there seating in the backstage, and I kept telling her how much I love her and I'm proud of her. That we can go way and beyond, you know. I wish her the best. She wished me the best. And because of that, you know, I took my time to still continue my prayers because I want this so bad. I know she wants it so bad. And I'm really proud that, you know, no matter where we are in our position is going to take us right now, we will go far. We can be an empowered woman, even with or without a crown.
Hi, Chelsea.
Chelsea.
I'm also from Bulacan.
Ah! Bongga!
Ayaw matalo, Bulacan.
Probably now sa festival of Bustos.
Yeah.
Ah!
My question is, your true to life story is very good movie material. If it will be adapted into a movie, what title would you like to be used?
And
who among our actresses would you love to play Chelsea and Mana?
Wow. This should be a life story of, you know, maybe a princess diaries. You know, she has not actually seen herself to be a princess. I actually love watching this movie as well. She never thought she was going to be a princess, so that was who I was, you know. But because of her mother who helped her, who loved her so much and dearly, she became one, you know, and she never changed herself. She never looked at her crown because of what can honor her for, but because of what she can do more, you know, what she wants to be. And if there is an actress, maybe I want to see Naomi, you know, Naomi Campbell.
Yeah.
Maybe people see it in me. So, yeah.
And who will play Mama Jane?
The
Tea Maker. Last question. Manny Halasan is one of the persons in the universe who is dearest to your heart. What is your message to him? And can you kindly tell us how and when you met him?
We met actually when I was about to join for Miss World 2017. He was one of the designers that one of my friend actually offered or recommended. So we met during that time. It went way, way back. So he supported me. He is actually a jewelry and accessory maker. Yes. But when he saw me, actually, he said that, oh, there's a potential there. He loves dressing up women as well. So he designed my dress during that time. And when I said to him that I want to join Miss Universe Philippines, he was the most supportive. He was there throughout my journey, through the whole journey of Miss Universe Philippines. He helped me get through it, and he said that, you know, I'll be there no matter where you are, and through Mexico, I'll be there as well. He helped me through my national costume and for my evening gown as well in preliminaries. He was my designer all throughout. So I love you, Kuya Manny. Thank you for believing in me. I couldn't have made it this far without you. I love you so much.
Yes.
Thank you.
Hello, Chelsea.
Hello.
I'm Annalyn from Manila, Bulacan. And we also come from
Bulacan. Ah, ay, bongo! Sana all! Bulacan na tayo lahat.
Ito naging taga-Bulacan.
Paranyaki ka.
Award mo kayo.
Oh,
wow.
One more relate.
Relate.
Did you have to choose from several, or yun na talaga yung decided na gown for the finals?
I really did trust Kuya Manny for his design and his concept. I think he also saw the styling that was really meant for me, which is, you know, she's someone who is very simple, really regal. She's humble, but she is ready to win a crown. So that is the inspiration to it. There is also a little bit of jewelry on the middle part of it, so that, you know, there is a little reminder of where I came from, and that is from Make Hawaiian, where many are known for jewelry makers.
So
Chelsea, yeah. And the second question, kasi you did not figure in the like special awards or even in the top picks of the forecasters, front runners. You were a dark horse, sorry. I just like to ask, did you ever doubt yourself at that point that you were not, you know, a favorite?
Well, this was always asked, and I would like to say that there's no such thing as any dark horse naman for this season. I mean, it's a bloodbath that they say, but it's more than a celebration of women. Kasi everyone really deserves it. Everyone is so beautiful. So during this time, sabi ko, I want to compete. I want to compete fairly. I want to compete at my best. You know, I'll just do what I do, and you know, I'll be as most authentic as I can be, because if I can stick to that, to that person, I'll get through the crowd. Thank you.
Hi Chelsea, my name is Nikki from Manila Standard.
Hello.
And I'm not from Bulacan.
I'm from
South Triangle. First of all, congratulations.
Thank you so much
during that night. Let's go back to the pageant night. What was going or running through your head when you stepped closer to the crowd? First, when you were called in the top 20, then top 10, and top 5.
So I'll go through it. Maybe when they called me for top 20, I remember I was the second to the last that was called. I was feeling nervous already. I was standing there, and I told to myself, when are they gonna call Bulacan? Why is it taking so long? But when they actually called it, I said to myself, okay, finally I'm a step forward. And then I said, okay, maybe I can go to top 10 lang, kasi to top 10, I'm okay na. You know, at least there is a placement to it. But, you know, I still stepped up. You know, I struck my way through the swimsuit competition. And then after calling to top 5, I said, it's the crown or, you know, nothing at all. So it was really destined for me, I guess. I prayed so hard. And the people who supported me, thank you.
Yes.
You had a solid performance during that night, but was there anything that you wish you did differently?
None at all. You know, I really was happy throughout my whole journey there, through the coronation. I remember when we are getting times when we can actually run to our dresser room, I would go to my phone and then I would call my mom and my team in Bulacan, and then I would always remind them, don't worry, okay, I'm happy, I'm calm, I am not worried, I am not nervous, so please just be happy for me and pray for me. That is what I was just going through there.
And my last question, when you face the mirror with the crown in your head, what was running through your head, what was in your mind?
Oh my God, I miss Universe Philippines 2022! That is what kept, that was burning into my head, because it really couldn't sink in. When I went back to my parents' hotel room with the sash and the crown, they were screaming. I said, please, okay, my ingay, may natutulog na. Okay, my ingay, may natutulog na. So that's what I told them. And well, everyone's telling me you're finally Miss Universe Philippines 2024.
And soon Miss Universe 2024.
Very soon.
Yeah.
Very soon.
Thank you, we're rooting for you.
Thank you so much.
Hi, good afternoon. I'm not from Bulacan, but
hello.
I will always remember you with our brownie, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, yeah. Okay, so as you prepare to the 73rd Miss Universe in Mexico later this year, so what's the important lesson that you've learned that you can apply universally regardless of your race, age, and gender?
You know, I think throughout the whole journey with my sisters, this is what really made me grow. I learned from each and every woman here. Being able to be with them, this is what I think I will take the most when I go to Mexico. That, you know, no gender, no color, no status in our life will ever hinder us to facing our dreams, to get a crown, or to at least be a leader or be a transformational woman. So when I get into that stage, I will always be reminded of them that, you know, you can be as an empowered woman no matter who you are, and I am that woman to set that bar, you know, to really tell them that you can be whoever you want,
just always be as kind and authentic as you can be.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Hi. Hi, Chelsea.
Hello.
I'm Charlize Legaspi from Business Mirror. Since you won, you've been likened to Wendy Fitzwilliam, Disney Princess Tiana, Janelle Comichon, and Naomi Campbell. Which of these women do you most resonate with and why?
Ooh, I think I resonate to every one of mine because it's all a beautiful woman, very empowering woman, you know. But I also want to just say that I think one of the women that I really also looked up to when I was a little girl was Tyra Banks. Mm-hmm. You know, she was that woman who really inspired me the most when I was also watching America's Next Top Model. So she's also one of those women. She's very womanlike. She's a very much a leader, really good spokesperson. And I think we both love ice cream.
My second question. You're an advocate for indigenous people like the Dumagats of
yes.
Bulacan. Now that you're Miss Universe Philippines, who are the other indigenous peoples that you'd love to advocate for?
So, of course, there are a lot of, I would love to work with Sultan Kudarat. I know when I went there, you know, we were talked to the governor, we met the people there, and I hope that I can come back there and work with them. But it's also really, my focus is to work with the youth, you know, to empower them the most and to really provide importance through education, because this is where it all starts, you know, when you build up their dreams, it starts there in education, they know what they want from it. So that is what I really want to work well with, and of course with the help of Miss Universe organization.
Thank you, Chelsea.
Thank you so much.
Hi Chelsea,
hello.
Congratulations.
Thank
my
you.
My name is Lindsay. I'm from A to Z. Going back doon sa coronation night, isa ako sa mga na-interview yung mother mo and she's not stop crying talaga. And then nabanggit din niya na yun nga daw, nabubuli ka daw noong bata pa. So gusto ko lang malaman paano mo na-comfort doon kasi syempre kahit paano everyone nakakaranas ng bullying and also give us a message na lang sa mga gustong maging Chelsea Manalo.
Well, I was bullied talaga when I was a little girl and it doesn't stop, you know. Somehow we will get to face those challenges even at our age right now. But I've always believed in myself, you know, because of what my parents have told me and because of the friends that I have been with, you know, they build up my confidence. And to the younger woman who actually wants to be a Miss Universe Philippines too, I hope that I can be already a reflection of you, that even if there are challenges that comes your way, you know, people will tell you that you can't dream to be a Miss Universe Philippines, then just go for it, you know, you can always take risks. There's nothing to lose about it. At least you'll grow from it. These challenges are just stepping stones for your greatness.
And also, syempre, you're the representative of the Philippines because I'm sick sa coming Miss Universe. Naisip ko ba kung anong kaibahan mo sa ibang mga kandidata?
I already know that I am a beautiful Filipina. I am a modern Filipina. I'm a very transformational woman. This is what will make me unique to be your next Miss Universe in Mexico City. So I hope that with the people who are here to continue to support me, this will make us go closer to getting that fifth crown for Miss Universe Philippines.
Introduction.
Thank
you.
Congratulations sa win mo ulit.
Thank you.
There are those who celebrate with you sa panalo mo, and there are those na have negative opinions about the win. What can you say to those people who have, you know, disregarded your win or have negative opinions about it? Yes, who doubted you?
I really don't want to focus on anything negative at the moment, especially the comments. As I have said, when I won the Miss Universe Philippines crown in the sash, I really looked up to my parents already and listened to them, those people who are really close to me, because these are what really matters the most. I know that with these negative comments, this is what only can just somehow it will bring people down, but it will never shake me down. You know, it will never take my crown down. I will always lift my head up. So I hope that instead of saying anything negative, is to just uplift, you know, uplift the candidates, uplift those who are really, you know, really deserving. I hope that this can continue until I get to Mexico.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Intro.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Hello, Chelsea. I'm also from Bulacan. Gustos Bulacan.
Hello.
My question, Chelsea, why should you be crowned as the Filipina Miss Universe?
Well, I should be the next Miss Universe and to be able to get the next fifth crown because I am just a woman who does not wear a crown and a sash, but it's more than that, it's an honor to give to the people. I am more than, you know, a reflection of a woman who is very humble, of having humble beginnings, and a sash that is really close to my heart because it reminds me of who I am, of the Philippines, you know, of who we are. And this will only transpire me to be more radiant because I am a woman. I am a woman of color, but I'm also a transformational woman that can really represent who we are as Filipinos.
Thank you,
Chelsea.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Intro. Here.
Ready na kayo?
Okay.
Chelsea, can you give us a sample of your introduction in Mexico?
Tayo siya. Pwede nakatayo.
Pwede nakatayo daw.
Sorry, sorry. Yeah. Wait, lang. Wait, lang. Wait. Wait lang,
wait.
Wait lang, wait.
Wait lang, wait lang.
Wait lang,
wait lang. Wait lang, wait lang.
Wait lang.
One, two, three, go.
Viva Mexico! This is Chelsea Manalo from the Philippines!
Woo!
Pwede isa pa.
Isa pa.
Ito na record. Ito na pindot.
One, two, three,
go.
Viva Mexico! This is Chelsea Manalo from the Philippines! Woo!
Philippines!
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, babe. Your message sa mga supporters mo and to the Filipino pageant fans.
Thank you all so much. To all those who are supporting me right now, to all of the La Bulaqueñas and all those people also from all around the world and all around the Philippines for keeping your close heart to your prayers with me. I hope that this can really just go further until I get to Mexico and get that next crown for the Philippines. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Let's
photo. Photo.
Photo.
Photo, please. Photo. Baba na lang natin yun. Yes. Photo.
Photo.
Solo.
Oh.
Here, Chelsea.
Chelsea Center.
Chelsea Center.
One, two, one more, Chelsea.
Center up. Chelsea here. Yung Voltaire na ano, no,
Chelsea, sir, Voltaire
the style.
Here.
Yung may pangiti.
Here.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Emmy.
Yan! Signature! Ayan.
Okay.
In Estancia, whenever they have their shoots and whenever they're in Estancia for a sponsor, I would always go out when I go to the bathroom or I go to Starbucks or something. I would always see him in the hallway, patiently waiting for her, like the whole time.
They have my luggage and everything.
Yes.
They're my stylist. They're my makeup artist. They're my driver, my PA, everything.
I hope Chelsea becomes an inspiration to other young women who want to join Miss Universe Philippines or any pageant, that you really don't need to have so much resources, that with whatever resources that you have, believe in yourself and know that if it's destined for you, it will happen. Chelsea went through a lot. There's some things that you know, that she went through that she hasn't mentioned, but these are challenges that she went through, but at the end of the day, she ends up as Miss Universe Philippines. And that's something that's a testament to one, her destiny, but two, to the power of prayer.
Chelsea, last question. How did you balance the crown?
Wait lang.
It has already been out on media, and I finally made it to the meme world. Well, the crown has a little bit of a weight. So when Michelle really put it on my head, because it's the crowning moment, it's the photo shot, photo, winning photo already. So I didn't feel like it was gonna fall because it was really in my head. So I thought it's gonna be okay. But until I turned on the side and it kind of slipped, you know, then Miss Michelle D already just fixed it. It was only a matter of a minute. Inayos din naman niya. So don't worry about it, guys. Oo, na-balance ko siya. So I think that's already enough to say that that is what makes a queen. You know, you have to balance it. Really.
Perfect!
Sample! You know, the whole time that was happening, nakaupo ako doon. There was a part where I thought, umakit doon, gusto ko tumakbo para ayusin. Because I was afraid, because Jewel Mar was there. And I was like, oh my gosh, like if it's gonna fall. How do I explain?
That's not. Yes. Oh, looking for last, no.
Si Anna
Lipusay.
There's this recently crown queen that we have, which is Alatea. So I really do look up to her. We have talked already, and she's really nice. You know, I look up to her. So I really congratulate her as well and wish her all the best. You know, she's there to support me, and I'm also there to support her. This only, you know, shows that how beautiful Filipinas are, how Bulacanas Filipinas, or how beautiful Bulacanas are. So I know that we are already a step towards winning more crown this year.
Oh.
When I go to the north, I pass through Bulacan.
you should go there.
Yes.
That's
we're gonna visit Bulacan very soon.
That's the connection. Actually, that's the connection.
No, but 2017 trivia. Yeah. I was invited to her debut because I was in Miss World Philippines. I was covering it then. Then the parents invited me. Tapos ayaw akong pumunta kasi or natatakot ako thinking like, oh my gosh, her parents are gonna be younger than me. But you know, ever since I've always told you you should join Universe. But at that point, I didn't know I was gonna be part of the organization. I didn't know what organization it was gonna be in. But every once in a while, I would message you, like, "Hey, are you joining this year?" And in 2018, when I was part of this one show, I even asked you if you would be willing to. And back then, you said your parents wouldn't allow you yet until you graduated.
Yeah, that's also one of the reasons why I was not on the pageant scene.
after Miss Universe or Miss World, I was 17 that time, and I was actually studying, so I had to juggle both. It was really challenging, and you know, I told myself if I'm gonna go back in the pageantry world, I have to finish college. You know, this is also one of my dreams and biggest achievements. And after graduating, you know, maybe it's Miss Universe for me, and finally I'm here.
Yay.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank
guys.
You. Thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you. Congratulations.
Official. Thank you, Miss Elgin.
Thank you, Miss
Elgin.
Thank
you, Elgin. Thank you, Belmont.
Elgin. Elgin.
Thank you.
One, two, three.
Thank you, Elgin.
Elgin. Elgin. Elgin. Elgin. Tatlong pagsak para kay Miss Elgin.
Huwag kayong ganyan, baka sumali yan next.
Hello. Photo,
Elgin.
Photo, photo.
I love you.
Photo
Miss
Elgin. Belmont. Miss
Elgin, photo.
Belmont. Belmont.
Photo with,
may special request on media photo with Miss Elgin.
Yes! Yes. Elgin! Elgin! Elgin.
Belmont, Belmont, Belmont.
Where's Mama Ru?
Where's Mama Ru? Ayan. Mama Ru! Mama Ru!
Mama Ru, Darin.
Ayun pala sa Mama Ru.
Darin!
Darin!
Ayan.
You know what, JP. What we love JP. About
si JP.
Chelsea is we get the vibe of Bea. The calmness of Bea. Yes. Come on now.
Jam! Si Jam! Si Jam!
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 Jam! Balik ka, punta ka doon! Request ka ni LG.
Oh.
Kayo muna.
Okay, ready?
Jam!
Center po.
Hold on, more photos.
Of course, photo with the media naman.
Yes,
there
lang.
Here
naman,
here. One more. Miss LG Center, here I, starring Mamaru. Alright.
Okay.
Tusali na si Miss LG next year.
Wow, Bongo.
Representing
Yudara. Wow,
this is siya. AP niya si Mama Hai.
Papress ko na, Miss LG.
With media.
Guys, guys, yung tiptoe niya baka mabilay.
Chelsea
won.
Group.
Group, group.
Wow, mabait si LG, no?
Groupie.
Ano kaya ka na?
Go, go. Dan pa dan, group, group. Oo nga, Drew Dan daw si Sir Nolly.
Yung mga nandito bawal.
Edge, bawal ka daw, Edge.
Dahil siya, Edge. Ay, Bobby,
Edge. May contract sign.
Siya? Saan?
Ayaw, di pa talo ni ano.
May kontrata.
I need your V name for you to see it.
Tito Nolly, labas mo. Jaryo.
Tito Lars, tahimik lang kasi may one-on-one siya. Tito Lars, pacheco. Hindi na wala.
Oh, ay!
Okay. Oh, thank you. Oh,
love
for all. Love for all. Love for all. Except
except dun sa mga hindi invited.
Ah!
That was from the crown. From the crown yung mga hindi nag-invite. One by one, please.
Love for all.
Love for all. No love for you. Thank you, Belmont. Thank you for a super yummy lunch. Masaya yung media. Piggy yung mga media eh, pero masaya sila ngayon. Na-impress, impress, yes.
Last thing too.
Thank you, everybody.
Last picture.
Thank you, everybody. Hindi na ito mauulit.
Ganon.
Ay, namatay na agad sa
akin. We have on stage. An upcoming resident of Las Vegas, Nevada, Armin Adina.
Loya, may message ako. Tingnan mo kung tama.
Soon to be married. Again, I repeat, Armin Adina, about to be married.
Ay, awarding ceremony. Thank you guys for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe. Also, on our YouTube channel and follow here. Watch our Facebook page. Bye bye.